All right, so if you have ever seen flashing lights, zigzags, or missing spots in your vision that kind of looks like this, then this video is for you. Today, we're going to be talking about migraine, and specifically that of migraine with aura. This is actually something that I have experienced and kind of dealt with since I was even a little kid, so I know exactly what it's like to go through it and experience it. And yes, it can be a little bit frightening, and that's exactly why I wanted to make this video. So today, we're going to review what a migraine and what a migraine with aura is. Plus, we'll talk about common triggers for migraine, as well as some tips to help with migraine relief. Plus, of course, when to see a doctor. But first, what is a migraine aura? A migraine aura is either a visual or a sensory disturbance that occurs either at the very beginning or just when a migraine is about to start. Migraines come in four phases. The first phase is the premonitory or the prodrome phase, where people often experience kind of mental state changes. For myself, I often experience mood swings. I also will have difficulty concentrating, and you can even have intense food cravings. For myself, it's usually craving high caloric foods like pizza, for example. So if my friends are ever around and I'm saying, hey, you guys, we should go get pizza, it could be in fact me heading that direction toward getting a migraine in the next few days. The second phase is the migraine aura phase. And for myself and many people, we experience visual phenomenon that often starts as like a small flashing light off to the side and then slowly grows and takes over almost like a C shape in your vision. Sometimes it even has like a very strong zigzag appearance or even a, like a rainbow appearance in your vision. The technical term for this aura is called a scintillating scotoma. Again, it usually starts off small and grows gradually, lasting oftentimes around 20 minutes or so, but can last up to a full hour before eventually fading away. If you ever do see this, it oftentimes does start off in one eye only, but then gradually you may notice it ends up being in both eyes if you kind of cover and go back and forth. That's because migraines occur in the brain where the visual fields of the eyes overlap. It is technically possible to have a migraine in just one eye, and that's usually a retinal migraine. However, there is some debate over the exact pathophysiology of that, and it's actually quite rare to have a retinal migraine. But in addition to these visual changes that people experience, some people can also have sensory abnormalities during this aura phase. This can include tingling of the skin, numbness, and even speaking difficulties, which if you're hearing that and you're thinking, that sounds kind of like a stroke, then, well, you're at least partially right. It kind of does sound like a stroke, and that can be really scary, so we will talk about that in just a moment. But usually, this aura phase is followed by the third phase, which is the headache phase, where you get this really intense, pounding headache, where people often do become more sensitive to light and sound. And that's why you usually find me hiding away in a dark room during this phase. But it is possible for someone just to have one of these phases of migraine without any of the others. So it is possible for some people to experience the visual phenomenon or the sensory abnormalities without ever experiencing the intense headache that usually comes afterward. And then for some people, they can even experience the fourth phase of a migraine, which is called a postdrome phase, or sometimes referred to as a migraine hangover, because people often feel not only nauseated, but they can have fatigue and even feel confusion for a time. And if you're someone who experiences migraine, then you probably know, check, 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 all these symptoms can really knock someone out for at least a few hours, if not an entire day sometimes. And if this sounds like you, definitely let me know in the comments what type of experiences you've had from these sort of sensations due to migraine. But now you might be asking, what causes migraines in the first place? Unfortunately, medical science still hasn't figured out exactly what causes migraines, but we do know of many common triggers for migraines. Some of the more common major triggers for migraine include that of emotional stress, a lack of sleep or poor sleep quality, hormonal changes, even strong smells such as cigarette smoke, for example. Certain foods can be triggers for people, including aged cheeses, processed meats, smoked meats, even caffeine and alcohol can all be triggers. One major trigger that I only recently became aware of is in fact my neck position or my posture. So if I sit at my computer for long periods of time in a poor posture, or if I sit on a couch or even sleep with my head in a weird position, that can trigger my migraines and even my visual snow syndrome. Visual snow syndrome is actually a completely different neurological condition where some people do see static in their eyesight, and it is associated with migraine headaches. So if that's something you have either seen yourself or you want to learn more about, I will put some links to other videos on that condition in the description below that like button for you so you can learn a little bit more. Now, what about migraine treatment and prevention? One of the first things that's often recommended is to keep a migraine diary or migraine journal so that you can document not only what type of symptoms you are having, but also write down what might have happened a few hours before or even a day or so before that migraine occurred, so you can kind of reverse engineer what your migraine triggers are and then make lifestyle changes to avoid those triggers. That's one of the reasons why I learned about my neck position and sitting in bad posture for hours, that can trigger my migraines. And once I figured that out, I was like, oh, that makes so much more sense. Even back to when I was a kid, I used to sleep on a huge pillow and my neck would be in a weird position and I'd wake up with a migraine. But again, I never made that connection till I started journaling and realizing these things. Now, if you do experience a migraine, a lot of people do report that drinking water, maybe eating some food, and then laying down in a dark, quiet room for some time helps alleviate a lot of their symptoms. If you are somebody who gets extreme light sensitivity during a migraine, then there are actually glasses that have been found to help people with those symptoms. This is such as an FL41 tinted type of glasses, as well as a brand of glasses called Avulux that are kind of more of a green tint. And if you want to know more about those types of glasses or filters, then I have done some reviews on those types of glasses before, and I'll put links to those in the description as well for you. Otherwise, some people do respond well to over-the-counter medications such as oral pain relievers, namely that of ibuprofen, acetaminophen, or Tylenol. There's also some mixtures of things like Excedrin, which have not only acetaminophen, but aspirin, and even some caffeine mixed in. However, if you do experience migraines frequently, at least twice a month, then definitely talk to your family doctor or seek care from a neurologist who may be able to prescribe you other medications that are specifically designed to help reduce symptoms and frequency of migraine attacks. Even Botox injections can, interestingly enough, be a treatment for intense types of migraine. Now, I just want to add here that I myself as an eye doctor do not diagnose or prescribe medications for migraine. I think if you're somebody who's ever had bad headaches or you have never been truly diagnosed with a migraine, it might be wise to seek care from a primary care provider or a neurologist to get an appropriate diagnosis. Now, with that being said, let's dive back in. All right, now let's talk about migraine aura versus stroke, because a lot of the patients who come in to see me after having a migraine aura often are worried either that they had a stroke or that they are having one right then. Now remember, a migraine aura comes on gradually, slowly builds into the vision, where in a stroke, when there's vision loss, it happens very quickly. In addition to this, migraine aura is a positive visual change, where this aura is sort of added to your vision, and then in a stroke, it's actually a negative change, meaning your vision is gone, like something is subtracted from the vision. Other symptoms of stroke you want to be aware of are that of facial drooping, arm weakness or paralysis, as well as slurred speech. If you think you are having any of these symptoms, then it is super important to seek medical attention right away. Acting quickly could easily save your life or help save someone else's life. So I thought I would just review all of that because it's worth a good review. All right, my friends, thank you so much for checking out today's video. I hope that this review of migraine and migraine with aura really does help you out. Please let me know in the comment section your favorite part of this video and share any of your experiences dealing with migraines or migraine with aura. Otherwise, if you want to learn more about different visual phenomenon, vision loss, or even that visual snow syndrome that I mentioned, then check out our next videos coming over here to the side. Thanks so much for watching. Keep an eye on it, and we'll see you then.